85(1), which provides that there shall be an auditor general for the Federation who shall be appointed in accordance with the provisions of Section 86 of the Constitution. Then Section 2 of Section 85 says that the public accounts of the Federation and all offices and posts of the Federation shall be audited and reported on by the Auditor General, who shall submit his report to the National Assembly, and for that purpose, the Auditor General or any authorized person by him, any person authorized by him in that behalf, shall have access to all the books, records, returns, and other documents relating to those accounts. And then subsection 3 talks about the limits of the powers of the Auditor General. It says that nothing in this section shall be construed as authorizing the Auditor General to audit the accounts or appoint auditors for government statutory corporations, commissions, authorities, agencies, including all persons and bodies established by an act of the National Assembly. However, the Auditor General may provide such bodies. They are known as parastatals. The Auditor General can provide them with a list of qualified auditors to be appointed by them as external auditors, and from which those bodies shall appoint their external auditor. And then, still under Subsection 3, it says that the Auditor General can now give them guidelines on the level of fees to be paid to the external auditors and comment on their annual accounts, and auditors' report there. Then Section 85(4) says that the Auditor General shall have power to conduct periodic checks of all government statutory corporations, commissions, those parastatals. Then Subsection 5 says that the Auditor General shall, within 90 days of the receipt of the Accountant General's financial statement, submit his reports under this section to each House of National Assembly, and each House of National Assembly shall cause the reports to be considered by a committee of the House of each House of National Assembly responsible for public accounts. And then, in the exercise of his functions under this Constitution, the Auditor General shall not be subject to the direction or control of any other person or authority. I quickly note that in Subsection 5 does not state what happens thereafter, after the report is submitted to the Public Account Committee of the National Assembly. So it has to be noted for the purpose of a discussion. Section 86 then provides that the Auditor General for the Federation shall be appointed by the President on the recommendation of the Federal Civil Service Commission, subject to confirmation by the Senate. And then Subsection 2 of 86 says that the power to appoint persons to act, that is, in acting capacity, in the office of Auditor General shall vest in the President. However, Section 86(3) provides that, except with the sanction of a resolution of the Senate, no person shall act in that office, no person should act in acting capacity as the Auditor General for a period exceeding 6 months. Section 87 provides that a person holding the office of the Auditor General for the Federation shall be removed from office by the President acting on an address supported by 2/3 majority of the Senate, praying that he be removed for inability to discharge the functions of his office, whether arising from infirmity of mind or body or any other cause of misconduct.